Hello, welcome to Sports on TVC Breakfast. We'll start from the home scene where the Atlas Lionesses of Morocco won the battle of the Lionesses of Cameroon's indomitable Lionesses with a 1-0 win in the ongoing Aisha Buhari Women's Tournament in Lagos. Fatima Tagnaout scored the only goal of the game played at the Mobolaji Johnson Arena. Our correspondent Solomon Ajiziogo witnessed the game and now reports.
After hosting the Super Falcons set the tone of the competition on the opening day of the Aisha Buhari Cup, it was the turn of the Indomitable Lionesses of Cameroon and the Atlas Lionesses of Morocco on day two. In the Battle of the Lionesses, the Moroccan women treated the spectators to free-flowing football and held out against the bullish Cameroonians for a goalless first half. With renewed energy, the athletic Cameroonian Lionesses stepped up in the second half. But Fatima Tagnaout broke the deadlock in the 79th minute through a lovely counter-attack.
This win today, it's mean for us a lot because we work hard. We know that a lot of players did just come to start the season. So I want to thank everyone. We come here just to win, and we want to improve ourselves and to see our level in with the teams, because we know that the teams that we are playing against, that they are powerful teams.
As regards the match that we have just finished playing, we wish to congratulate Morocco for this victory. They worked hard for it and they achieved it. They had one opportunity in the game and they seized it. We didn't take our opportunities. Besides, we still congratulate them. Let's forget about fighting their fighting. No. In the spirit of fair play, we accept the defeat and congratulate Morocco.
The performance of Morocco reflects the development of the women's game in the North African country, driven by UEFA Champions League winning coach Renaud Pedros.
Pour travailler, on savait qu'on avait deux matchs très difficiles.
You know, we really work hard to get to this stage. You know, there are a lot of players, you know, who want to play, you know, even in Europe, back home, and all they want to play. And you could see that the players played without fear. They played because they wanted to win and all, and that's exactly how it all came about. We combined a lot of things together, discipline, tactics and all, and we could all see the result.
Et qui, en fin de match, a su se sublimer pour aller chercher cette victoire.
The Moroccan ladies next play against Mali, while Cameroon take on Ghana. The three action in the Aisha Buhari Cup will see the Banyana Banyana of South Africa tackle the Black Queens of Ghana. Solomon Ajiziogo, TVC News, Onikan, Lagos.
Well, the Aisha Buhari Cup is generating a lot of buzz and attention, and of course today we'll see the Black Queens of Ghana taking on Banyana Banyana of South Africa in the Sixth Nation Women's Invitational that continues in Lagos. Away from Nigeria now to Europe, where Nigerians are also getting the spotlight, and in what was a battle between two Nigerian strikers, Leicester City were forced to a 2-0 draw by Napoli at the King Power Stadium in England, with Kelechi Iheanacho and Victor Osimhen scoring. Well, Kelechi started by providing an assist for Leicester's second goal, while Osimhen scored both goals for Napoli. On the other hand, Wilfred Ndidi was sent off for a second bookable offence to cap an eventful night for the Nigerians. And another Premier League team, West Ham, were on the winning side after beating Dinamo Zagreb 2-0. Bayer Leverkusen edged Ferencváros 2-1. Real Betis outscored Celtic by 4-3. And Lokomotiv Moscow settled for a 1-0 draw against Olympic Marseille. Elsewhere, Monaco peeped Sturm Graz by 1-0. PSV Eindhoven were forced by Real Sociedad to a 2-0 draw. Olympiacos beat Royal Antwerp by 2-1, while Galatasaray got the maximum points at home against Lazio.